My training camp is going great at the moment, and I've had a pretty long camp this time, so my conditioning should be at the top comes fight night. I have a face, I have an opponent, so the intensity goes up and we get ready for war.
Zebaztian Kadestam defends the belt successfully. He says he wants his reign to be long.
Now that I'm the champion, I feel I have to push a little bit harder because I know all these guys are coming for me. I like it, but it's not like, oh, I'm the champ, I can stop. No, this is just the beginning of my journey, so I'm excited for the next years to come. My mentality has gone from chasing something to more like, oh, these guys are coming to take something that is mine. Nobody's gonna come and steal something from me. Mixed martial arts is such a weird sport. Two men enter, one man leaves, so the pressure is always very big. But as a champion, there's a little bit more pressure. I don't know how to explain, but in a way, it's better pressure.
Zebaztian Kadestam, the downward elbow, the crossing elbow. It's good night, Irene.
For now, my goal is to defend, but my biggest goal is that I wanted to become the first ever MMA world champion, Muay Thai world champion, and boxing champion. This is something that has always been in my mind, even before I joined ONE Championship. And now, it's not a dream, because I have the opportunity now with ONE Super Series to go after another world championship. There's no other organization in the world that gives these kind of opportunities. I'm looking into the ONE Super Series, not only because I want to join, but it's the highest of highest class in the world. And I feel all the Muay Thai fighters, all the kickboxing fighters, they're the greatest. So if I could join that rank, then I would be super happy. The last 1-2 years, I've been developing into a whole new mixed martial artist and a martial artist. I'm not going anywhere, and I know all these guys, they're coming for me. And I'm here, I'm ready.
Maguire says, what will happen when I take Kadestam down and deliver 100 unanswered strikes? Michael Schiavello, Mitch Chilson with you. It's for the Welterweight Championship of the World. Overhand right early there from Maguire. Look out for the elbows on Zebaztian Kadestam.
Low guard coming from Maguire, but immediately shoots it for the takedown. Good job by Zebaztian Kadestam to back it up, not necessarily accepting the takedown. Good footwork on his part. Now he's back up to his feet. Good job by Zebaztian Kadestam.
Kadestam had a 7-week camp, worked on getting in shape, improving his cardio on takedown defense and choke defense. Strategy, of course, no streaker to keep it standing. If it goes to ground, he wants to be top position, have the wrestler on his back.
Maguire's got to lift up his guard a little bit. I know he likes the lashy Taekwondo style. That was where he started with, but he's got to keep his hands up. Sebastian Kadestam's got power.
Maguire, though he likes to choke out most opponents for his finishes, says tonight he will beat Kadestam with punches, either on the feet or on the ground. He had a much better camp than last time against Luis Salas Santos at a full stable. Lots of fake lefties, lots of high-level wrestlers. Working with Michael Chiesa, Sam Cecilia, Austin Arnett, lots of great training partners. As he plans to take Kadestam to deep water, believes the Swede is a little too durable to finish it early on.
That jab is touching up Maguire. You can see, you know, Kadestam letting out that jab. Maguire's got to keep his hands up a little bit. He's trying to bait Kadestam in. You can see the back movement. He's trying to get Kadestam to overcommit. Kadestam's a veteran. He's been there a lot. Champion.
Kadestam did say that he believes that McQuire is open to leg kicks. Not worried about the wrestler trying to catch his leg. Says his leg could be too hard and too powerful for McQuire to defend against. Especially to the calf. And there's one that hits the calf of McQuire, and his legs seem to buckle for a moment. Look for Kadestam to damage the legs downstairs and maybe go for the headache maker, the roundhouse kick. Good to the back of the neck.
There's a difference between the leg kicks of Kadestam and the leg kicks of McQuire. You can see McQuire's leg kicks are landing with the foot, which creates that slap, but there's a thud to Kadestam's leg kicks because they're landing with the shin. Very different. They sound different, but they feel remarkably different when that shin connects.
What worries me for McQuire is his hands are around his waist and his chin is exposed. He's not tucking and looking through the ground. Kadestam doesn't go down. Second attempt here, double leg. Now gets Kadestam on his back. This is where Tyler McQuire wants to be.
He's trying to lock up those legs, and that's what enabled Kadestam to back up, but he kept that grip nice and tight around the legs, and he was able to drag him to the mat. But he's also not anywhere near the cage. Last time, Kadestam was able to use the cage to get back up, but this time, McQuire was able to put him down in the middle of the ring. Cage, rather.
Is Tyler territory. This is McQuireville. Kadestam trying to find a way back to his feet. Almost gives up his back. Now he's there, the swing. They're about to strike it. The crowd appreciating the resilience, the defense of Zebaztian Kadestam. Looping the counter from the swing.
It's got to do wonders for the confidence of Kadestam to get away from two takedowns and survive some dangerous positions there.
Let's see if Kadestam moves in close and unmurals those elbows. The crazy elbow arsenal on Kadestam. Quiet and still low, circling into the power side of the swing. Takes it inside, they keep the back leg. This one, the one championship welterweight world title.
Wire's chin's out, his mouth is open, his hands are down. I'm sure Kadestam sees exactly what we're seeing, and he's just waiting for the right moment.
Kadestam showing patience.
Lots of movement coming from McQuire, though.
Not remaining a stagnant target, has to stay mobile. There's a left hook to an outside leg kick from McQuire. Hasn't shown anything in the hand so far. Good phase. Kadestam turning back, kick looking for the liver.
That landed
outside leg kick from McQuire.
That landed flesh, Michael, right in the back. Right into the stomach, the midsection. Ben smiled a little bit as the El Matador. Zebaztian Kadestam fades the spinning back kick thrown by McQuire.
Tremendously entertaining opening round here. Lazy high left roundhouse there from Kadestam. McQuire, oh, just threw him off. Beautifully done from Zebaztian. And we're run round down.
I like the way, see, look at this. See how he's backing up? Look at this, good balance shown by Kadestam. This was the first takedown attempt. Then McQuire was able to scoop the legs out and secure the takedown. He was able to use the cage to get back up. The second time, Kadestam tries that same defense, but watch the turn. So McQuire turned off the cage, put Zebaztian down in the middle of the ring. But then in the third attempt, he was able to shrug him off. So. Those are two dangerous positions where McQuire was in a dominant position and Kadestam was able to get away. And then in that last exchange, Kadestam was able to throw him off. And I'm not seeing a lot of the striking elements of those good, clean techniques. Those coaches got to be screaming at him to keep his hands up, tuck that chin, and be a little bit more conventional in your boxing stance.
You're watching the largest martial arts organization in the world. It's one championship. It's our main event from Jakarta, Indonesia. In front of a magnificent crowd at Stadium Astora for the one championship welterweight world title. America's Tyler McQuire undefeated. The striker from Sweden, Zebaztian Kadestam. Kadestam thought about the front kick. McQuire, left hook to right cross. Huge deltoids on Kadestam. Looks in tremendous shape here, the Swede. Watch those slow turns. Kadestam trying to get inside the mind of McGuire's mouth. It's an outside leg kick. Those leg kicks will make it harder for the wrestler to shoot in on his opponent.
You've got five rounds, Michaels. We're going to pay dividends, especially as we hit those championship rounds.
Shortly from Kadestam, down close. McGuire resets, center of the cage. Now backs up. Kadestam thrust out the jab. Instructions in Swedish, being barred from the corner of Kadestam. A tango back against the cage now.
Good job by Kadestam to get that underhook on that side. He was able to throw the leg kick. Tyler caught it, and then he charged forward. Because Zebaztian Kadestam is showcasing tremendous balance. Even though he's been caught a couple of times on a takedown defense, he's doing really well in evading these takedowns by demonstrating fantastic balance.
The welterweight championship that Ben Askren held for so long in the USA. And Tyler McGuire looking to take it back there. Looking to pass it on from one American wrestler to another. Single leg here from McGuire. Where does Kadestam go from here, Mitch?
See, he's trying to use that overhook on the right side, that wizard, to keep Tyler McGuire upright so he can't drop down and attack his legs. So he's doing a good job there. He's going to try to circle out to the right there, but Tyler McGuire's driving his shoulder right into the chest of Zebaztian Kadestam, so he's not able to do it. Now he changes levels.
Who's using more energy here? Is it McGuire attempting the takedown or the defense of the takedown from Kadestam? Who's exploring more?
Well, I think it's muscle memory at this point. Tyler McGuire's been wrestling since he was a little kid. And Zebaztian Kadestam has only been with any takedowns for, you know, 10 years now. So I think Tyler McGuire is much more efficient in his takedown and utilization of energy.
Kadestam trained in the five rounds, and he wants to take McGuire to deep water, gas him out. Expected fireworks in the first round. Expected McGuire to bull rush him. And the more it goes on, the more it's in my favor. I've got the cardio, not him.
See that body lock? See how he has the hips laced like that with his arms? It's going to be really hard for Zebaztian Kadestam to get away from that, even to defend the takedown. Once your opponent locks their arms around your hips, you're going to go for a ride. Zebaztian Kadestam's got to let go. Now Tyler McGuire's got the hands. He's utilized the wizard to get back up to his feet, though. Good job by Zebaztian Kadestam, but the pressure on Tyler McGuire is still very intense. Look at his head position, right under the chin of Zebaztian Kadestam.
Likewise, after an eight-week camp, McGuire also said he'd take Kadestam to deep water, said the sweep was far too durable to finish early. McGuire said he trained in a shark tank in preparation for this one. Mitch, he was swimming with some great sharks, some very high-level wrestlers in that training camp, and said better prepared than ever before, particularly better prepared than he was against Lewis Santos.
Yeah, the shark tank is an intense way of training. It's multiple opponents coming in on you during the duration of a round. So every 1 to 2 minutes, you get a fresh guy coming in and wearing on you. Really develops your conditioning because you're constantly working with a fresh opponent. It's just a way to skyrocket your conditioning, and that's where he's really trying to get to because he knows this is a championship match. He's got five rounds to do this. And look at his style. He's always on the balls of his feet. He's always moving. He's always threatening takedowns, so he needs a huge gas tank.
And he's going to his left and go into that right power side of Kadestam. Kadestam unable to cut off the movement of McGuire. 20 seconds remaining, second round of five. Welterweight championship of the world. I think we'll find the midsection again there, Kadestam. McGuire tried it. Kadestam gets it. Almost a jumping side to flank it. For the audience here in Jakarta.
The thing about Zebaztian Kadestam is that the first two rounds, he usually tries to use those rounds to figure out his opponents and really try to figure out what they're doing. You know, here you can see him trying to defend the takedown, but this is when Tyler McGuire locks up his hands. And once his hands are locked, you are going for a ride. Look at that, just driving him with the shoulder, secures the double leg. but it's a perfect point to kind of cement Zebaztian Kadestam's game plan. You can see that Tyler McGuire, as Zebaztian Kadestam cuts off an angle, that's when he threw the spinning back kick, right as Tyler McGuire drifted into that range of that spinning back kick. Zebaztian Kadestam is figuring out Tyler McGuire. Tyler McGuire's got to step things up. He's got to take this to his world. He's got to take him down and wear on him.
We are traveling towards that prophesied deep water that both men spoke about. Inside Stadium Astora, Jakarta, Indonesia, the main event of one championship warrior's dream. And for the welterweight title, Sweden versus the USA. Let's see if Kadestam can work those leg kicks. Queried McGuire about which strikes of Kadestam he had to be most careful of. He said the elbows, and he just catches Kadestam with a nice little popping right hand there that the Swede did not expect. Front kick from Kadestam. Jab two from McGuire. Kadestam thrusts out the jab. McGuire waiting for the time to shoot in and get a takedown. Hopefully put the Swede on his back. Said he would knock out Kadestam with his hands, either standing up or on the ground. Continues to circle into that power side of Kadestam. Kadestam not capitalizing though.
Watch, Zebaztian will try to cut that angle off and get Zebaztian to go into this weaker side. And he'll throw that spin back in.
Right there from Kadestam. Lots of the cage being used by 11-0 Tyler McGuire from the USA. Born in Iowa. Now for great wrestlers, none more so than the great Dan Gable. Outside leg kick from Kadestam. A few fakes and feints here from the Swede. How much energy is all this movement taking out of Tyler McGuire? We're three rounds in here, Mitch, and there's lots of the cage being used by the American.
And you can also start to see Zebaztian Kadestam is starting to attack the body. So that's going to be trained on Tyler McGuire even more.
Kadestam used the tongue fix to try the meet and greet knee. McGuire just got out of dodge in time. Wild punches off the right hand there from Kadestam, then goes downstairs to the legs of the wrestler. Now McGuire shoots in to no avail, however. Good defense from Kadestam. And McGuire forced to reset. Big liver shot there from Kadestam. And then the outside thigh kick.
The movement, it's definitely expending a lot of energy, but Tyler McGuire is a high-level wrestler who is used to conditioning, he's used to putting in time, doing the road work, so I don't think his conditioning is going to be a problem for him. It's eating these shots that are going to be the problem.
That big buckled a little with that thumping roundhouse kick just above the knee. You hit that common peroneal nerve. It's about four fingers' breadth above the lead knee. It's where he pops his hip to literally deaden the leg. Like said, Andy Sauer, and this guy who's so effective in their careers.
McGuire's trying to lace up that leg. He's trying to go for an outside trip. Might fall to his right here. And he sticks his leg out to try to trip him. He's trying it. But good balance so far by Kadestam. He's got to turn and go chest to chest with McGuire and then start digging for underhooks. He can't let McGuire sneak around his back like that. He has to put his back against the cage to prevent McGuire from doing this.
Kadestam takedown defense again from the Swede. 1:29 remaining, third round of five in this mixed martial arts contest for the welterweight championship of the world.
Now he's got his back up against the cage. Now he's got his back up against the cage. Now he's got another hook. Now he can get away.
One strike, accidental there, and there'll be some recovery time for Tyler McGuire. How about the balance though on Kadestam? His ability to remain vertical when McGuire wants him horizontal.
I think he learned a lot from the bout against Ben Askren. You know, that's one of the world's greatest wrestlers. There's a low blow there landed by Kadestam. Caught him flush on the groin, but, you know, he learned a lot from his battle with Ben Askren. That was a lot of ground time that he spent on one of the best wrestlers to ever transition into mixed martial arts. And Kadestam has grown from it. He's developed from it. He knows that that was a hole in his game, and he's kind of filled that hole, Michael.
Kadestam advancing towards his corner here. He's looked good so far. Injury time for Tyler Maguire. He is allowed as much as 5 minutes for medical examination and recovery. Decision will be given if he can't go on. Groin strike. When you get hit to the groin, it signals launch to the brain at a speed of 265 miles an hour. It's your body giving the brain notice that something is terribly wrong. Pain is also felt in the abdomen because that area shares pain receptors with the groin. Some of these signals are what make you want to grab your stomach, bend over, lie on the ground in the fetal position. Unlike the pain you get from ice cream, an ice cream headache.
Oh, it's not enough from pain like an ice cream headache.
The perineal and the pudendal nerves. The spermatic plexus, which feels like death has come from the lower part of the body.
It's like the worst ice cream headache in the history of the world, Michael Shabella. How dare you compare a groin strike to an ice cream headache?
You will never look at Gelati the same now, Mitch. 5 minutes allowed for Tyler Maguire. Ridiculously high number of sensory nerve endings in that groin area make even the slightest touch very noticeable. Looks like Maguire has managed to shake it out, get everything back in place. And we're okay to continue here to the third stanza. On the hunt, on the prowl, with his striking. Maguire looking for the opening to take the Swede down. Kick there from Kadestam. Down of danger there from Maguire. Kadestam with the jab.
You see that? Kadestam swept out the feet when he started to circle to the left. Right as he was about to circle, Kadestam went after those legs. Zebaztian Kadestam is a very cerebral martial artist. Picking his shots wisely. This is a very unconventional offensive strategy from, you know, a martial artist to constantly move them like this. The gas tank that Tyler Maguire has is intense. He has been on his bicycle for like at least 12 minutes running around the cage.
Kadestam going back to those leg kicks, aiming to drop the top of the shin, that tibial tuberosity on the head of the quadriceps muscle on the thigh. Oh, jump-tated back kick! The Swede gets airborne! What a way to end the round! Great gap, two to go.
Let's take a look at some of Tyler Maguire's handiwork. Beautiful counter, right hand, right as Kadestam came in. Maguire came underneath. There he is going after the legs. That didn't drop him, but he did drop him earlier, later in the round as he swept out the legs, as he started to time and figure out Tyler Maguire's movement. Very interesting third round. Now we're getting into the championship rounds. These are the rounds that are going to determine who is going to leave Jakarta with that welterweight strap around their waist.
Two more rounds to go here in Jakarta. Zebaztian Kadestam and Tyler Maguire for the one championship welterweight world title. Inside Stadium Istora. Magnificent setting for a magnificent main event. Ready? Referee Olivier Coste gets us underway. Penultimate round. Love to see Kadestam go back to the lead thigh. Look up there from the sweep on the back foot, hard to deliver.
Kadestam's timing these knees right inside the clinch. Once he gets the hands underneath Maguire's arms, he delivers a beautifully timed knee. So Tyler Maguire is not able to catch the knee or close the distance to get a takedown of his own. The knees are very well timed.
Maguire looks like he wants a standard trade with Kadestam. Nice defense again there from Zebaztian. jab from the Swede. Left hook, needs to throw more combinations though. Did not just rely on the single punches.
Well, it's hard because Tyler McGuire is constantly moving, so he's not there for the second punch.
Slow down that movement with leg kicks. McGuire did believe that he had the striking prowess to finish Kadestam on the feet with the punches. Kadestam overhand right, but unable to cut off the movement of McGuire. Chop walking right hand there. Licks his lips and smiles. Overhand right, put him on the orbital. Nicely done there from Kadestam. Turning back kick. McGuire caught him. Now he's got Kadestam down, but can he take the Swede there? No! Wrenches him back down to the canvas. And Kadestam back to his feet. Well done from the Swede. Oh my word, the captain Kadestam has been working his defense.
His escapes are definitely something he's been working on, and he's shown tonight. Tyler McGuire is used to grabbing onto opponents and not letting go, but Zebaztian Kadestam is so slick. He's utilizing balance, he's utilizing movement, he's getting away in an unconventional way.
After 3 minutes remaining, fourth round of five for the Welterweight Championship, live from Jakarta, Indonesia. You're watching 138 countries around the world. Hope you're enjoying the largest martial arts organization on the planet. Turning back in, hoping to find the liver. Upper right portion of the abdomen. Wyatt peppers with a jab. No right hand for company, though, from the American. And his arm showing some creativity in his guard at the moment. Overhand right there. Kadestam seeking to hurt him with those sorts of punches. A little bit of showboating now from the Swede. Nice jab. Needed the right hand down the center. Outside leg kick. That's more like it from Kadestam.
That's going to slow down the movement of McGuire. Attack that lower leg. Start beating on those legs.
McGuire doesn't look like he knows how to check the leg kicks of Kadestam. Striker versus wrestler. Of the two styles thus far, the striker seems to be the one who's had the more success, Mitch.
Yes, he's starting to touch up the face of McGuire. He's starting to land these shots. I'd like to see him keep going back to that leg, because right there, that left leg is hanging out there for McGuire, or for Kadestam. Showboating, he's entertaining the crowd. He looks like he's having a really good time out there.
Turning back in from McGuire, Kadestam looks to just brush it off. Spin there from McGuire, that was dangerous. Kadestam though couldn't channel his inner Mark Newell. Right hand to the midsection there from Kadestam, hoping to put the belly button through the back. McGuire comes over the top with a turning hook off the right hand, and Kadestam rides the body shot, says you've got to do more than that, you've got to hit harder, Tyler. Do you see this as Kadestam trying to psych out Tyler McGuire with the showboating?
I think he's trying to get into the head of McGuire, and he's doing that because he did miss a couple of shots, and you can see, you know, Kadestam, you know, showboating a little bit, smiling at him, sticking his tongue out, looking up at the rafters. But what McGuire's doing, he's changing his game plan. So if he misses the head, he goes to the body like he was doing. Then Kadestam's forced to go, yeah, that didn't hurt so much, but he's still landing, he's still outpointing. The judges aren't looking at the showboating. That's for the fans. That's for the people watching on TV. But Tyler McGuire is not really changing his game plan too much. He's still staying smart. He's still looking forward. He's still trying to attack.
Four down and one to go for the Welterweight Championship of the World.
Nice little overhand right there from Zebaztian Kadestam. But I would like to see him limit the showboating, limit the, you know, the kind of the flamboyantness right there. Beautiful little catch right there from Tyler McGuire, but Zebaztian Kadestam was able to get back up to his feet and keep this thing where he wants to, and that's standing.
Okay, Mitch, let's play, coach. With one round remaining, first of all, what are you telling Tyler to do?
Tyler McGuire, he's got to kind of go all out here. We got to see those flashy kicks. He's got to do a big knockout. I think he's behind in the scorecards. He's got to look for a finish. I'd like to see him start punching into a takedown. He's just kind of been shooting in. He's been diving for the takedown. I'd like to see him throw that 1-2, change levels, slide under for a takedown. For Zebaztian Kadestam, I'd like to see him go for the finish, start hammering on that leg, go for some head kicks, and really start throw the showboat in his side and start putting some heat on his hands and try to finish this match.
The cage door closes. The fifth and final round from Jakarta, Indonesia. Who will become the welterweight champion of the world? Will it be Kadestam of Sweden? Will it be McGuire of the USA? Inside leg kick from Kadestam. Both men have gotten to the deep water they spoke of. Now let's see whose prophecy rings true. Throws him off to Kadestam, hooks off the right hand, just falls short, maybe clip the whiskers of McGuire. Goes to the liver, overhand right to the jaw. Left hook, right hook from Tyler McGuire. McGuire breathing through his mouth, evades the jabs, the double jab of Kadestam, a little too slow. That's up the kick from the Swede. McGuire goes to the jaw, doesn't have the starch behind that right hand. Fires an uppercut, went so high, I heard organs playing. Front kick there from Kadestam. McGuire looking a little worse for wear, a hematoma under the right eye, little cut under the left eye. Fakes that from McGuire. Hands just don't seem to have the power to rattle Zebaztian Kadestam.
Good job, Zebaztian Kadestam's digging for an underhook on the left side. He's trying to pull Tyler McGuire up. Tyler McGuire's trying to attack those legs. If he can lock his hands, he might be able to take Zebaztian Kadestam down. Zebaztian Kadestam's got to try to pull him up, keep his legs separated, keep his base nice and wide.
3 minutes 15 on the clock here in Jakarta. Kadestam looking at referee Olivier Ghost. McGuire wants Kadestam on his back. Get the sweep there now. Kadestam. He's out of trouble. He's sensing frustration here, Mitch, on Tyler McGuire.
A little bit. He tried to, you know, initiate the takedown, but Zebaztian Kadestam was able to stop him yet again from completing the takedown. He has landed a few. He's got to be careful. He's got to keep his hands up. That right hand just connected.
Maybe another cut just to the side of the left eye of Tyler McGuire now. His face certainly tells a story of the jabs, of the crosses, of the hooks from Zebaztian Kadestam. Past the halfway mark of this fifth and final round now. Kadestam with a left hook. A right hand though, follow through. There's the right down the corridor. Again, stuffs another takedown attempt. Shot to the top of the noggin there from McGuire. To walk forward, does Zebaztian Kadestam. Have you ever seen him back up? Not in his repertoire.
Tyler McGuire hasn't been pushing forward. He's been pushing forward when he shoots for a takedown, and that's when Zebaztian Kadestam's backing up, utilizing that balance.
That took an uppercut combination there from McGuire. Just doesn't have the power. Kadestam just throwing single punches now. Overhook on the right arm from McGuire. Chance for the knees or the elbows here for Kadestam. He's got great elbows. They haven't come into play yet in this championship match. May we see them now? Kadestam has been smiling, showboating, enjoying himself in Jakarta. Doesn't look like much enjoyment for McGuire. His face is lumped and cut. Hasn't had success with the takedown. Locks onto a low single, gives up on that. Kadestam turns back into him, throws a high knee. A little minute remaining now. Jab two from Kadestam. Crowd would love to see a finish. We're in the deepest of deep water now. Sloppy shots there. Nothing on the uppercut from Maguire. Both men fatigued now. 30 seconds remains. Oh, Maguire! How about that? It's over. It's good night, Irene. Zebaztian Kadestam is the champion of the world. Zebaztian Kadestam knocks out Tyler Maguire. It's gold for Kadestam. The Bandit steals it like a thief in the night in the final seconds of the match.
Zebaztian Kadestam waits again until the last chunk of the round to finish Tyler Maguire with a huge putt. Look at that right hand. Catches Tyler Maguire right on the button. Shoots in. Throws a knee to the down opponent and just knocks him cold.
That huge punch and Tyler Maguire astral traveling. The first loss of Maguire's career, the biggest win of Kadestam. Tremendous scenes here in Jakarta. Zebaztian Kadestam KOs Tyler Maguire in the dying stages. I have injured his knee or his ankle. And look at the respect, the sportsmanship, the martial arts code of honor, the Bushido spirit. That's what it's all about here in ONE Championship. What are they saying to each other? Just two fantastic athletes. Kadestam has done it. And he's done it with a huge knockout. There is your new welterweight world champion. A Swedish champion. Let's go to Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 32 seconds in the fifth and final round for your winner by way of knockout and new ONE welterweight world champion, Zebaztian Kadestam.
And there's the rain of gold over the cage in Jakarta. And the rain of gold begins for Zebaztian Kadestam. A dream realized for the Swede. He grew up on the wrong side of life's tracks. He turned his life around through the martial arts. And now he finds himself at the top of the martial arts world. He finds himself as the ONE Championship world title holder.